fænomen, Devon Nunn. Han er instruktør, producent, forfatter og skuespiller, og han er en af de tre største stjerner i Indien gennem de sidste 40 år. Devon Nunn har planer om at lave en film i Danmark.
I've just started. I came 2 days ago, and I think I'm going to be here for like 6, 7, 8, 10 days, and I'm going to film myself with all these experiences, and then go back and do a script, which I think would be fascinating for the audience. Not only in India, I think all over, because I think this experiment has not been done yet, to my mind.
Do you have a pattern in your head, a small story, a skeleton of?
No, there's no pattern yet. The pattern would grow with all that I collect within myself and go back home. But it's going to be a good big motion picture, not just a small one. Because now you must know about me, and I write my pictures. I'm basically an actor. I've acted for more than 45 years. I started as an actor. And when you've done so many motion pictures, and you have an audience that sees your motion pictures, and you want to do something different, and you're creative, and you want to be a writer, and you are a writer, then you do want to branch off as a film director and as a writer. So there came a stage when I wanted to do my own pictures, and I started writing. And the pictures that are not normally done by my other colleagues in my country, because when you make hits, you're in a certain type of a groove. When you want to grow out and do something different, then you branch off and do something different. So the types of pictures that I am directing, or I have directed, are the pictures mostly conceived by me, in thought, in content, and the complete screenplay.
Devon Nunns film er blevet set af næsten alle i Indien, og der bor 800 millioner mennesker. Derudover er han også et idol i Mellemøsten, og han laver som regel film med lidt usædvanlige temaer, som for eksempel i den her Des par Des, der handler om de indiske immigranter i London. I filmen skal han til London for at undersøge en brors forsvinden, og ombord på flyveren møder han en ung indisk. En af de ting, der fascinerede Devon Nunn mest i Danmark, var hans møde med Christiania.
Christiania excites me as a subject matter for cinema, though the fact also remains I've not yet decided. I'm only collecting notes. To me, this is a good aspect of cinema in Denmark. Not there, many others are not there. And if Christiania can exist here, if Christiania can be shown in the motion picture, why not? It's still there. So I want to get more facts about Christiania. And it's only after I get the facts, I think, then it becomes good film that provokes, that tells about a point of view.
You saw Christiania first time.
Isn't it nice that people should know if it exists?
Of course.
That's it.
But the first time you saw Christiania, it told you something for the cinema part, as a visual thing. What was it? Was it the darkness? Was it the houses?
No, I thought that here was a world which was totally on one pattern. And the pattern was probably only on drugs and nothing else, which I did not see anywhere else in Copenhagen so far. Though I've heard about Copenhagen and I've read stories about Copenhagen. It's a free country, it's a free port. But this particular area was so different, strikingly different to me. So it got stuck there. Now that doesn't mean that this is the only theme I'll pick up. Probably I would, I do not know. But I'm collecting lots of things so that my mind is totally full. And then I'll go back and isolate myself for 7, 8 days. Go through a period of tremendous turmoil inside me. Close my eyes, bang my head against wall and see what should be done, what should not be done. Hundreds of pages will be written, so something will be thrown off. And out of those hundreds of pages, a film, 12,000 feet, 14,000 feet, 10,000 feet, will grow. That's how it happens all the time.
I Devon Nunns film Des par Des, som betyder hjemme og udland, så vi før hans møde med den indiske skønhed i flyveren. Han bliver en slags værge for hende, og de bliver begge to ansat i en pub i London. Den scene, vi skal se, var så våget og ophidsende, at inderne så filmen igen og igen for udelukkende at nyde den. Devon Nunn er også kendt for at lancere nye unge ansigter i sin film som Tina her i Des par Des.
Unnatural, yes. Unnatural. But commercially acceptable. People loved it. Because again, there's a little difference between realistic art and so-called art cinema. To my mind, there's no such thing as an art cinema or commercial cinema. Cinema is cinema. And cinema must be seen by the maximum number of people. And it is commerce, because you spend a lot of money on it.
Hvor mange penge han vil bruge på den dansk-indiske film, står hen i det uvisse, men det bliver en stor produktion, som både skal laves i en engelsk og indisk version. Jeg spurgte ham, om han vil bruge danske skuespillere.
I think a project of this nature, where my film would be set in Denmark, at least 80 to 90%, would certainly have a cast of which will be a blend of Indian and Danish actors, or European actors, or people living here who would give an impression of being Danish. I see strong potential of a very, very, very good-looking girl from this part of the world to be in the picture. She need not be an actress. She need not be a model.
Is that the most important thing?
I do not know. Not the most important thing. Because I visualize, because I think that will give a contrast of what I do want to give a contrast of different types of cultures in two parts of the world.
Is that because you love to watch a beautiful woman, or is it because you know the audience wants to?
I'll put you a question. Who would like to watch a beautiful woman?
I would love to. Manuskriptet er færdigt nu, og det bliver spændende at se, hvordan en indisk instruktør opfatter Danmark. Jeg synes nok, man får en lille fornemmelse af det her. Han har allerede en ny film i skrivemaskinen, den skal også laves i Danmark, og inderen har planer om at spørge denne danske skuespiller, om han vil være med. Men ham har man ikke kunne vriste et svar ud af endnu.